Hey, how are y'all today? Welcome to the kitchen of Love and Light. And I did get a new journal. I want you to see this because this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Look! You know, I love a food journal. And earlier when I was buying this, I found three in a pack for $4. And what I like about these is the lines are small and I can fit a lot of details on the page. And I was thinking to myself earlier, like, do you ever think that I'll get to a point where I won't use a food journal? I really love to do it because I can look back and remember why I feel so dang good now, not what's gonna make me feel good or what worked, what didn't work, because it all works every day. And I don't have to think, oh, well, can I feel good? Can I feel vibrant? No, I'm just hoping that someone picks up when I'm laying down so they can come on up and fly on the high vibe with me, because it's lonely up here, you know? But I wanted to tell you this. First of all, where do y'all keep your Dulce Flakes? I keep mine right here. Look, sometimes they're in a Debbie Meyer green box, which are my favorite way to store anything because they last longer. It doesn't matter what it is, but I had these in a glass bowl with other glass bowl things the other day to make, you know, a cute presentation. So anyway, here they are, and I like to get about a tablespoon of those a day. First of all, I like for the iodine in there. I like that it's good for the thyroid health. I like it because it's salty and savory, right? But I want to tell you this too. Another way to get your salt on is if you're going to have Swiss chard, which is my favorite, which by the way are very beautiful and clearly a great earring or beard. Anyway, these are great wraps, okay? And you don't have to worry about what you're gonna wrap your stuff up in. If you can digest grains, if it's gonna make you sluggish, grains don't work for me. And they haven't for years. They didn't for 5 years before I went raw. And now I'm like, why did I even wait 5 years? Like, I wanna feel my best, okay? So even though sometimes I do some crackers and different things like that, or wraps in my dehydrator. The main thing I like to use is wraps of kale, or I really like butterleaf lettuce, but I mainly like Swiss chard to wrap things up. So I want to tell you this, when you're making your Swiss chard wraps, okay, let me show you what I've got going on right here. You see, these are just little wraps. They're wrapped up in there. You see, I just displayed this, which is why they're already out. And then this is my delicious dip, everything I need and nothing I don't. But pretty much you're going to take the chard and you're going to lay it flat, and usually I like this to put my goodies on the inside. And then I would take my knife and I would go up the side and cut the main stem out. I would put my goodies right here. I would flap this up and flap this up and roll it around, okay? But what I want to tell you about that's pretty obvious, right? I'm not telling you anything you don't know. But this part right here, don't throw it away because of the salty deliciousness. You can clearly juice this, but also you can chop it up into little fine pieces, and as you see, it makes a little salty hit. And this is like a cut the fat guacamole, which basically has half of an avocado, some of the Swiss chard chopped up small, the red. It has the Dulce Flakes. It had some, a little bit of cayenne, 1½ lemon peeled. It had some celery and a little bit of jalapeno and some green onions. Oh, and it had 4 dates. Y'all, so delicious. See, right there you've got a salty component of the Swiss chard and the celery. You have the fatty component of your avocado. You have the salty of the Dulce and the celery. And you have the sweet of the avocado. And that is gonna hit every mark on your little taste buds. That's gonna make you satisfied and make you say my name, right? So anyway, think about that. Think about how when you're on this long enough, your taste buds readjust, okay? Because this tastes salty to me, okay? I mean, it has a salty taste. And before it wouldn't have tasted salty because salt tasted salty, right? But when you're on this long enough, your little taste buds are gonna change and you can be satisfied and you can be doing other things rather than just living to eat. You can eat to live and then you can live your life, you know? You can live your life feeling good, disease free, you know, not worried about can you fit in your pants. I fit in my pants every year, year after year after year. And when I go shopping now, I'm excited, or go to the Goodwill to see, like, I don't know. I'm just saying, you do not have to live feeling overweight. You don't have to live lethargic. You don't have to live disease ridden. Your body's just at dis-ease. You understand the difference in that? It's at dis-ease, meaning it will be at ease again if you give it a chance. If you get out of the way, stop putting in the toys or things we call food stuff that are making you sick. Get out of the way, give your body everything it needs and nothing you don't, and you can live your life with freedom. People think that this diet and lifestyle is restrictive, but it's complete freedom. It is freedom. More than anything else, more than body freedom and disease freedom and any of those things, it is freedom. It is free thinking. It is freedom for me to think for myself, do for myself, be about myself so that I can be all I can for me so that my cup is filled and tipping over and pouring out to those I love, right? So anyway, I just wanted to tell you that, and I wanted to tell you to get your salty Swiss chard on. And I just wanted to give you a bite. Do you want to have a taste test? Because this is messy, and I don't want to hear your judgment if it gets in my teeth, okay? Just you please ignore that. And if you can't ignore it, then you have a teeth food judgment problem. So salty. Are y'all getting a good look at that? Phone, don't fail me now. This is a time to focus, okay? Look. Delicious. I'll have to go now because I have a date with the Swiss chard, okay? Sometimes I just want to lick things and this Swiss chard is good, that's all I'm saying. Do you understand? Anyway, I love you and I'll see you later, alligators. Back in the kitchen of Love and Light with Tanny Raw. Tanny TV! Bye! Going down the only road I've ever known. Listen, I forgot to tell you a while ago on the little guacamole was that you had also your acidic component, which was the lemon. So bam, night night, see you later.